Parshat Pinchas opens in describing the, or naming the dramati personae who did a horrific thing, one that staggers the imagination as to how it could have occurred at the end of Parshat Balak. The Jews are still within the first year and a half of the desert experience. They've just come out of Egypt, and they stood at Sinai receiving their Torah a short while before, a year and a half before. And there was terrible degradation. The situation was horrendous. The Hebrews were freely cohabiting with the Midianite and Moabite women round about. And there was a public act of such cohabitation between a prince of the tribe of Simon, Zimri ben Salu, together with a Midianite woman, Cozbi Batsur. And Pinchas, seeing this act in front of Moses, and Moshe Rabbeinu remained silent, perhaps because his wife was a Midianite woman, and it was difficult for him to speak out. But this was a public act of the worst kind of lewdness in front of Moses. And it would seem that this would mean the end of the Jewish people. Certainly the end of a Jewish people committed to God and Jewish law. Pinchas the Kohen took matters in his own hands. And he's the zealot. But what's really fascinating is, how could such a thing occur? So close to the miracles of the Exodus and the giving of the Torah. In order to find the answer, I think we have to understand one thing. The five books of the Bible are named usually by the first words, the opening words of the book. The book of Genesis, the book of Exodus. This is the book of the desert, Bamidbar. However, it's called in Latin the book of Numbers. And numbers in terms of censuses. Why are numbers or censuses a name for this book? And I think the rabbis came to that discovery because they felt that the answer to the question I asked at the beginning can be found if we look at the twice taken census, in the beginning of Bamidbar and here, Pinchas, in chapter 25 of Bamidbar. The first census is very interesting. Each individual was counted. The Mishpachotam, in accordance with his family. Rashi says, tribe, going all the way back to Abraham, the father of our nation. That was the Mishpachotam, the tribe going back to Abraham, Levet Avotam, the parental home, the father's name. Kol zachar legulgalotam, every male in accordance with his personal name. Those were the names of the census in the beginning. At the end, Pinchas, many, many chapters later, because in the beginning of Bamidbar, the Jews were all set, the tribes were together, the sanctuary was their center, and they seemed ready to conquer the land of Israel. Everything fell apart, and they didn't come to conquer. They were afraid to conquer. And public lewdness and immorality. And it looked as if Jewish history was ending even before it began. And they took a second census. But the second census doesn't mention Lemishpachotam. It doesn't start from the tribal families. And it doesn't go back to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. It starts only with the father's name. And there also is no personal name. What does it mean? It simply means that when the Jews came into the desert and spent a little time in the desert, with a kind of abandon of the desert, wild nature of the desert, lack of orderliness, and study of the Torah, which took place in the desert, missing. The Jews somehow lost their past history, lost their family names, their tribal families, lost all of those magnificent stories of the first patriarch of Israel, Avraham Avinu. Avraham Avinu, who discovered God himself and discovered God's laws himself. Avraham Avinu, who says that we must become a blessing for all nations. That was missing. Their personal names were also missing. Because the Jewish person is the Jew who is eternal and goes all the way back to Abraham. The Jew who only had a father, not a grandfather and great-grandfather, not a grandson and great-grandson, is hardly a Jew. That's what happened. That's what caused the terrible, terrible disintegration of the Jewish people. That's what allowed for the public lewdness. And it's fundamentally the Benot Slavchad and their commitment to Torah that brought the Jews in the desert back to Jewish traditions, back to their truest family names, back to their beginnings. And only when they were able to go back to their beginnings would they be able to begin a meaningful future in the land of Israel. Shabbat Shalom.